Welcome to Creating Your New Course in Canvas. In this portion, we will be discussing modules. It is important to think of the module index as effectively a filing cabinet that will hold all of your course content. You are going to organize your materials here to deliver them to your students. Each module is much like a drawer in that file cabinet. Labeled on the front of the drawer tells users what is in the drawer, what types of content they will locate there. Modules hold information for a set type of organization, whether you choose to organize your content by topic, week, unit, etc. Within that drawer module, we put things such as pages, assignments, quizzes, discussions, files, external tools, or external URLs. Much like we would not just throw our papers in a file cabinet drawer and expect to be able to locate them later, we need to keep them organized. Using text headers, we can label portions of the module much like we would label an individual file folder within the drawer. Within our Canvas course, we proceed to the Modules Index page from our course navigation menu. From here, we will see the template module that has been provided to you. If you are looking in a migrated course, you will see modules based on each item that was available in your content area navigation from Blackboard, the thin black bar that was available on the left side of your screen. Each item there has migrated as a module. To begin creating modules, we use the plus module button at the top right of our screen. We are then asked to provide a title for our module. Again, you can organize your modules by content, topic, unit, calendar week, whatever makes the most sense for your course. You do have the ability to lock a module until a certain date and even a specific time by checking lock until and providing a date and time. When we're done, select Add Module. All new modules and all new content is added at the bottom of our screen. To get there quickly, consider using the Collapse All button to hide any other content that's expanded. Here we can see the new module that we added. However, we can also see that that module is empty. We have created the file drawer and now need to add content. To add content to it, you have two options. You can add existing content, or if you are building out a new course, you have the ability to create placeholders. From the module header, the gray bar where the title appears, we select the plus button off to the right. Using the drop-down, choose what type of content you would like to add. For example, if I wanted to add a page, I can select page from the dropdown. If you are adding an existing page that is already a part of your course, you will see that laid out in this list. To create a placeholder for a new page, select Create Page and give the page a title. Indentation works much like an outline. If you want to help students stay organized, using those text headers in conjunction with the indentations will help them visualize how to move through the content effectively. We'll look at that in just a moment. Now that we've added our title, we can add the item. Note again that this is simply a placeholder. There is no content in this page until we go back later and add it. if you are building a new course, we recommend building out with placeholders. It can be frustrating as we adapt to have to go back and rewrite directions or re-explain things in a different way because we have reordered how we present our content. Using placeholders will help you nail down the order you wish to present your content before going back and adding in the specific information. You do not have to choose specifically between only using placeholders or only using existing content, as you do have the ability to mix and match as you build. For example, if you wanted to update your welcome page, but wanted to keep the first piece of content you have, we could use the plus button to add an existing assignment by choosing assignment from the dropdown and choosing that assignment that's already part of our course. You have the ability to add any combination of assignments, quizzes, files, pages, discussions to your module. You can use the external URL tool to link students out to a specific website. You can decide whether that loads in a new tab or within the window and add the item. This will provide students with a direct link to that external tool. If you use something like VoiceThreads or Kaltura video quizzes, you can add those as well by choosing external tool from the dropdown and choosing them from within the list. You have the ability to add those voice threads, specific YouTube links. Please note you also have the ability to embed these within a specific page. Let's add a few more pieces of content by going back to the top and adding a discussion board. Again, we can create new placeholders or use existing content. And we still have the ability to mix and match those. It's important to note that your classic quizzes will be denoted as such in parentheses at the end of the title, while new quizzes will not have such a designation. Once we've got our content built, we want to make sure that it's organized. We can use text headers to do that. From choosing text header in the list, I can select all of the deliverables to label clearly for students as things that they need to turn in. Using the 8-pack icon to the left of each item, I can drag and drop and rearrange my content. For example, the deliverables for this week would include the discussion, the quiz, and that week one assignment. It's important to note that you are not required to put all of the assignments together in such a manner. It is important to put them in a place that makes sense within the module. For example, if we were to provide students with readings from one of our files, we would want the assignment or discussion related to those readings to immediately follow it. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit clt.odu.edu.